In this video, discover a free tool that will revolutionize your content planning and social posting.
Now we've got to admit, we do love a really good spreadsheet, don't we? All those rows and columns and formulas. But this tool is about to break up that long-lasting love affair.
It's called ContentCal. Take a look.
Take a look. We're not actually going anywhere, we're staying right
it's
here.
It's not out that door. It's not.
No. It's going to appear on screen.
Like, now.
Yeah.
No, it hasn't happened yet. Now.
There we go.
So this is ContentCal, and it is a social media planner and a publisher. So it will actually publish to Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn for you. But what's really cool about it is that you can use it to plan all your other marketing channels as well. So we have set up some planning channels here for YouTube, for our blog, for ConvertKit, and for MailChimp.
I approve.
So once you have set that up, you will get your calendar view here. And as you can see, we've got our publishing tools in here, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And we also have our planning profiles as well. When we are creating content and putting that into these top four publishing tools, it will actually publish on our behalf, where we're just using these bottom four just to kind of plan things out and know what's going out well. So once that is all set up, we can actually start creating our posts within ContentCal just by clicking new post, saying where we want it to go to. So let's say we want this to go to Twitter. We want it to go out tomorrow. You can start categorizing your content into different buckets, and you can even add media, videos, or GIFs.
Not bad.
Now, we don't recommend posting a photo of yourself on every tweet, but it shows how prepped we were for this. And once we are happy with our post, we can just click schedule.
Nice.
Now, a really cool feature we love about ContentCal is if you click into any of your scheduled content, you can see what it's actually going to look like on the platform that you've scheduled it for by just clicking on this preview post on platform button.
Nice.
Another really cool thing it's got is this whole post backlog area. So if you've got any kind of random thoughts or random ideas or random things that you want to create content on, then you can just create a little catch-all section here to catch all of those ideas. So we just click new post. Say if you want to create a post on Pete getting new shoes.
That would be a great social media post.
Yeah, with pink bows. And we want to save this idea for future. We can just click save to backlog and it is there ready for us to create in the future. Great for never forgetting an idea.
And then you can just drag that in, right?
Uh-huh.
Boom.
Drag that in, click in. Maybe upload the photo of the pink shoes, flesh out that post a little bit. And Bob's your uncle. Now that is handy. Another thing we love about ContentCal is that it's got this whole approval scheme part to it as well. If you are working maybe with a social media manager, or you are a social media manager, or you even have multiple people in your company creating posts for social, you can set up an approval process so things only get posted once it's been through everybody. So you could have step one, right, first, we want this to go to the editor. And step two is the manager, and step three is the director. So everyone has to sign off on it before it actually gets posted. And we set these people up as users. So every time a piece of content gets scheduled, they get an email to say, this has been scheduled, approve it, or even suggest some alterations to it.
I mean, that's a really cool feature, don't you?
We can also add notes on each day if we want to be reminded of something. So for example, on Thursday, we might want to say it is Dance Like a Robot Day.
Let's do a throwback Thursday.
We can also create campaigns, which may be for things like launches of some kind, or maybe campaigns around certain times of year. We can set the start date and the end date for these campaigns. We can give campaigns a description to keep everybody on the same page, and we can even add in our media assets for this campaign.
So good.
So once you've got that set up, and when you come back to your calendar, you can see what campaigns you have got running currently.
So as you can see, it does a whole ton of stuff and it's not even expensive. In fact, if you don't want to use the multiple calendars or the approval process, you can use it in your business for free.
But then if you do want to use it with your team or with your clients, then there is multiple different levels depending on how many calendars you need.
So what are you waiting for? Go check it out.
You know what though, Pete? A content calendar is no good without amazing, remarkable content to fill it. You don't want to be scheduling boring, unengaging stuff.
So to create remarkable content, you need to grab yourself a ticket to go watch Remarkable Content, the movie. You can watch this at remarkablecontent.biz. And it talks about the 7 things that you need to do to create amazing, remarkable content that's going to get shared and that's going to grow your business.
Grab it at a link around this video somewhere. I've been Andrew.
And I've been Pete.
Please subscribe if you've enjoyed this, guys, and we will see you next time.
Bye.